or just plain prince. Did I miss anybody?
You better know that the taboo exists.
don't know what the taboo is. You can walk in here, make the same mistakes, and never know. I listened to a couple of young men when they overheard this conversation. They were talking about art. They were artists. One knew he was an artist because he painted the paint on his nose. Toe up to the top, and the veins dripping up, and the splashes here, little shapes over here. And he was proud to have it. And yet, it's cut off of work. His turtle was hanging in the gallery there. And with a $5,000 or $10,000 price tag on something. One of the worst pieces in my opinion. And he was annoyed with nobody bought it. I spent a lot of time on that. He says, you know, I put a lot of work on this. Nobody buys my stuff. The other one was concerned because he painted variety of things. He had one piece that was very realistic, another piece that was very abstract, another piece that was very surrealistic, another piece that was something else. He was all over the board. Okay? And his reason for being all over the board was he was trying to appeal to everybody. And no concept of what art was, what he was. No concept of politics. No concept of composition. No concept of design. It was heavy. They jumped on the bandwagon, an artist, and they jumped at the wrong end. They jumped on the end that says, I want fame and success instantly. I don't want to go through the hassle. So, I'm saying to you, you can differentiate between that which has quality and that which doesn't on the basis of those who have gone through the hassle. There are obviously exceptions. There's some that never do. I think that's all I know. Okay, don't look at that anymore. I'm going to show you some examples of things that I think have some qualitative aspects to it. Tommy, you around? Okay.
Basket curves, fruit curves, plate curves.
did it on purpose. Trust me. You look at 100 paintings that he did, he manipulated space in similar kinds of ways. Okay.
Painting
Bowman and even with the parts left off.
Yeah.
So in a sense, she's taking the future money and made it three-dimensional.
Such a great role. I didn't want to stop you. I'm enraptured. Please continue.
Go back down. This is a truck series. This is a charcoal. The truck series does element involved in that. And it's used in number of little things along the back of the cup, you know, right things and washing them under each other. So there was a connection to mankind involved. And that cigar was very comforting down and eventually evolved some other things. And that means the feeling that's from the drug series as well. That was the introduction. This one is remnant series. Remnant series and truck series were around the same time. Remnant series had to do with little bits and pieces of things. Papers, ticket stubs, etc. Laminated into painting. And the painting was mostly acrylic. So this one has a TWA painting.
This is an early Wall Street. Wall Street came about
accomplishment, and dark animal, dark animal, forces you to deal with two major tables at the time. And then they link together with the dark cross field, dark cross field, and so forth. And, this is very long series, 1990. This is very large. Michael Jackson's image was part of the poster that was held. I saw this poster in Midtown, and I went back to get it. And when I got here, it was a piece of the air, even though I was cheating. And I said, okay, I won't believe it. And that was going on forever. So I wasn't really cheating.
Do you want a cue? You want a cue for wrap up? Or do you want a cue for wrap up? It's all optional.
These are all from the 80s, 90s. titled Madness Wall, Urban Fantasy. And Dirk Bradley Davis, that's he was in it. I think the Mark Fletcher, this is the Gallery of Philadelphia.
Thank you.
anyone who's interested in helping that from God, I wanted to show you a couple of spirit voices in this. There's a head here. Hair, eye, nose, very large. There's another one in here. There's several in here. And there's a figure in here. Okay. And this is the detail of that same picture. And I think there's one more piece in that particular. This is not an issue.
And think about how you want to affect people from afar. You know, my concern is when you get it?
When I'm working, I do move back and forth. I get close on the work, I have to see what the overall composition is looking like, what I might need to do next. But at the time that I'm thinking about that, I'm thinking about the work. It's me and it. It's not me and the audience.
Right.
The audience doesn't enter into this. My job, my goal. And I don't need a conversation. This is me and it. Eventually, now this would be done in Europe. Yeah.
I'm sorry. You have assistants, artist assistants?
I did mention that I have artist
assistants. Oh, so how do you know where you and his name
came? Because I know what it was that I asked him to do.
Thank you.
that appear in the work. Now, well, there's two things. The shadows, those figures are generally people on the margin of the life. They're old, they're crippled, they're weak, poor, and they walk past the wall and don't see. Sometimes they don't see themselves. And that happens a lot in society. We tend sometimes not to see things we don't want to see. So those shadows fall at one time. The little figures that show up as spirituals are things that emerge from the wall itself. For the most part, I didn't plan on them. They happen in the process, and after discovering them, I would embellish them. There are some that keep happening now. Most of those just kind of merge in the wall. And it's as though the wall itself has been there long enough that it has absorbed. And all things have come at it. And now there's an opportunity to communicate with you through this force. That comes actually out of the series I was doing earlier. The reference to the communities is called the Solar Spirits. It's based on the large state, and in that state, they lived through the desert, they absorbed everything that came out of them, the birds built a nest in, the rovers built a nest in, people, the dark side, the shy, the dark side, and they absorbed all those things. Quickly with time, one to a month, the outer skin falls away, and then the spirit bulk comes out. So what was left was kind of humanoid looking, or animalistic, and it was though. The first one I saw, it looked like, I was looking up at it, it looked like it was crying. So I just said, my life is over. Here, take everything that I know. That kind of relationship was what kind of inspired the spiritual relationship. But this Lost Spirit series kind of stopped a few years ago. Make on that again. Any other questions?
Not all of your thought process, not your secrets. But did everything, even that appears to be two-dimensional, feels three-dimensional that you've done in the show. It feels so much of a joining of the second and third dimension. And I wonder, what came first? Were you thinking three-dimensional or two-dimensional, or did it conjoin?
I don't know if I can answer the question in the way that you want to hear it.
I didn't think it was going to be an easy one.
Okay. What I'm working on is something. I don't think it feels two-dimensional or two-dimensional.
I can't hear you.
I tend to think in terms of the relationship of the things that I have in front of me, and whether they become two-dimensional or three-dimensional depends on how they come together. So some things that started two-dimensional somehow added another element. It might not be very much depth, but there's some depth. For example, there's a piece in the last room, in the last piece on that wall. It's called Quiet Control. It's very quiet. And it started out very flat, but it has to have a three-dimensional quality to it because I added a suspended element that sticks away from the surface. So that necessitated frames of a different space between the frame, between the glass and the piece. And while that's a very limited amount of space, it moved from a flat thing to a kind of three-dimensional thing on the basis of what was happening in the process. Not that I started out with the notion that this is going to be two-dimensional, this is going to be two-dimensional. You know, whatever happens, happens. Mm-hmm. Will I become a sculptor? Probably not.
But I just want to say about this one piece here. When I saw it in a hanging, this one, I saw it as a really three-dimensional piece, even though it's on the wall, it's hanging at the,
you know. That place happens when there's a gallery, that's when it's sticking out. Artifact. Sometimes it's hard to display. Like things like this fishing line that comes down and goes into a box.
Yeah.
You know? Plus.
Well, anyway, it's beautiful. Beautiful.
Thank you.
those vast and glorious